A is 50% more than B, C is two-thirds that of A, and D is 60% more than C. Now, each of A, B, C, and D is increased by 10%. Find what percent of B is D after the increase. Okay, so here also since none of the values are given to us, we'll assume the most powerful number in percentages, that is 100. So, in the very first statement, you have been given that A is 50% more than B. Then here you will be assuming the value of B to be 100. So if B is equal to 100, A is given out to be 50% more than that. So A would be 150. C is two-thirds that of A. So C becomes 2 by third of 150. This gets cancelled out. So C becomes 100. 2 times 50, 100. And D is given out to be 60% more than C. 60% more than C. So 60% of C plus C. This will give you 60% more than C. So here there's one more concept which can be learned over here. If whatever is given out to be in percentage value, let's say in this very same example, if D is given that it is 60% more than that of C, instead of writing this equation, you can directly add 160 percentage, that is one point, this would give you 1.6 times, and you can directly multiply it with the income of C, right? This thing saves your one step over here, because all you are doing is you are first finding the 60% of C and then you are adding it to original C. Rather than adding it to original C, you can directly write 1.6, the factor of 1.6 over here, or 160 upon 100. Okay, so here C is given as 100 to us, so D becomes 160 in this case. And now we have found out all the values. A is equal to 150, B is equal to 100, C is also equal to 100, and D is equal to 160. Now it is given to us that each of these values are increased by 10%. So 10% of 150 is 150 into 10 by 100, right? So these zeros get cancelled out. So there is an increment of 15 for A. So 150 plus 15, 165. Similarly, you do the same process over here. So B becomes 110 because 10% increment. C also becomes 110, and D becomes 160 plus 10% increment, 160 into 10 by 100. Again, these gets cancelled out. So you add 16 to it, 176 becomes your D. Okay, so now all the values are given to us. The question asks what percent of B is D after the increment. So you can write over here that D is equal to X percentage of B, right? So you should be writing 176 is X percentage of that of B, that is 110. This is how you calculate the percentage value of one in term of other. Of is given out to be here on right hand side, so B's value would come here. So if you solve this, the zero cancels this, so this big X percentage value becomes 176. The zero goes to that side, 1760 upon 11. So you can cancel this by 11 times 1, 11, 6, 6, 11 times 6 is 66, and then zero. So actually, D is X is the percentage value, so D is 160% that of B after the increment, right? You can simplify this process by directly putting it over, directly dividing this 176 over B, and you can multiply it by 100, and you should be getting the same answer, that is 160.
If you like my lecture, please subscribe to my channel. You can also provide me feedback in the comment section so that I can make the required changes and improve the quality of videos as well as the content. You can also join my Facebook group as well as my Facebook page, where I provide regular updates as well as regular PDFs and test on a daily basis. I have Telegram channel as well as Telegram group also. You can join those also. There I provide regular PDFs as well as regular tests. The name of Facebook and Telegram groups and channels is Success RBI or Success SBI. There's a mobile app also. The name of the app is Infinity. You can join that app. You can download that app, and that will allow you to take quizzes just like you take a quiz in the real scenario when you go and take the examination, the government examinations. So that will help you get a better idea and take regular quizzes of phase one for RBI as well as SBI.